Stephen Powell has always been drawn to color and light. Working in glass allows him to capture the natural colors of Kentucky, the blues of the sky, gold and reds of the fall, and pinks of spring. Color and light melting together in gem-like luminosity that provides a moment of wonder.
I thought it was a great idea. I'm not, I know, I mean, the whole, we have a piece or two in other hospitals, and I've always liked that idea that it's sort of, you know, art is healing or therapeutic, or I know it is for me. I don't know that it is for everybody, but I think what University of Kentucky did is certainly unique. I don't know of any other situation where there's so much art. It's almost like it's designed around the art in certain ways, and I'll be interested to hear how patients react to it. When I was going through graduate school in a glass program, it was almost like you weren't supposed to make beautiful objects. You know, you're supposed to make something more controversial or, you know, social statement or something like that. But I've always approached my glasswork as beautiful objects. And so I think seeing beauty to me is kind of healing, makes me feel better. You know, even if I'm not feeling bad, it can make me feel better. So I guess if it's in a situation where people are feeling bad, maybe it can at least make them feel better. Whoa. I think we decided that we were going to try to make a bigger statement than just one piece, so we picked pairs, if I believe my memory serves me correctly. So we had a bunch, I can't remember, five or six pairs that we had, and when we're making a pair of pieces, we don't make them thinking they're going to go with another piece. So we basically went back and looked at a bunch of pieces and picked pieces that seemed to go together, whether it's certainly the size and form, but color also. Go ahead and hit the back. Watch his hand. Well, when we did the book that University Press of Kentucky put out a few years ago, we had to sort of categorize what we've done. And our first series of pieces that were definitely more influenced by the human figure, maybe some vegetation. They were roughly symmetrical. You know, double lobe pieces that, you know, we throw names in them that encourage that relationship, such as double lobes with cleavage and buns and, you know, things that people can interpret however they like. And then at a certain point, we switched to making asymmetrical shapes. And so we made a whole series of pieces that we called wackos because they were such a very wacky process where we not traditional glassblowing, where we blow the piece out, we're attached on another end, and we are up in the air, hanging it down horizontally, totally American, not Italian or traditional. And those are very, very like animal-like, like aardvarks, anteaters, definitely animal-like. And then we took those in our last series we call screamers, which we then basically took that and went upright back into more of a vessel orientation. They look more like cranes or swan, you know, definitely like animals that could be, you know, screaming, I guess.
All right, Stephen, let me cool down just a little bit.
Formula. In fact, I sort of scoff sometimes. I hear, you know, of books or classes or you know, on color theory. You know, are they supposed to teach artists how to pick colors? I think that's kind of silly. I mean, you can talk about, you know, where colors are on the color wheel or something like that, but some people just, you know, pick color. I mean, I just pick colors that I think will work together. It's a little different in glass because you're not just picking the hue or the actual color of the piece. You have to be familiar with, you know, and the other things like saturation, you know, mixing colors across a color. Anyway, but you have to also be aware of how strong the color is in glass. In other words, if I put a certain blue in one part of the piece and it doesn't blow out as much as the other part of the piece, then it may be too dark for that spot, too intense. So you have to really know the density or strength of the colors too in glass. So it's a little different, a little more to it in dealing with the colors in glass. Yeah, I mean, the teamwork element is obvious if people come, you know, see us work. You'd be very limited working alone. So the team that I have assembled right now are pretty high, you know, they're different skill levels, but I have several that are very skilled. And everything has to happen just right. Sometimes we might seem a little short in the studio, but it's gotta happen. I can't, you know, you can't go, oh, bring the, you know, I gotta have it now. Because when you know, open the doors, I mean, the glass is moving, you know, most of the time. I mean, you want to work the glass really hot if you can. And so things have to be, you know, all set up and work really like clockwork. I've had it described as it's like having a baby, the birthing of a baby. I don't know how that, I haven't been through that one, so I can't, I don't feel that much pain, I know, I don't think. I mean, there are times where it's hard and, but definitely choreographed as a dance. We definitely always listen to music. In fact, I bet you didn't get much on the recording because I don't think we talked much. I'd be almost curious. We're so focused on what we're doing, and most of our signals between each other are, you know, like just a nod or a very slight physical gesture. So we probably didn't get a lot of audio, but. We listen to all kinds of music, and that's probably, you know, it kind of keeps me young in a certain way, because they love to listen to, of course, the best music ever came out of the 60s and 70s, and they all admit that, but I do listen to, you know, new music, and we take turns sometimes, you know, who controls the music in the studio, but it's a real part of working together. I mean, the whole, what we do, you know, and for me, it's not, I don't know, it's kind of divided in different things. You know, the gallery scene, showing pieces, lighting pieces, that kind of thing is one aspect of what I do, but for me, it's not the main thing. What you saw, being in the studio, making the work is what drives me, you know, as an artist. If I couldn't go back and do that, I'd be totally frustrated and depressed. You know, I'd like to think my work shows that we've gone through a lot to get to that piece. You know, I don't know that, I mean, we know we have, we know what goes into the work, and I think that might give it strength. But we definitely have failures. I think from watching us work, you might get a sense that things could could go wrong here or there. They almost did today. We had a little trouble, you know, certain colors react differently to heat, and we're always mixing colors. We're not careful. You know, if I want a blue and it's too soft and it's going to cause problems, we use it anyway because we want that blue. But we definitely, I don't know what percentage, but we learned to deal with disaster and things going wrong at times, though it's never really easy. But we know we can go to the next piece. You know, we know we're going to get back in the studio. That's the main thing. So we may be slightly down if we broke the piece, or like, in fact, the piece before we did the piece that you filmed was a disaster. You know, we got to the last move and it just wrinkled and collapsed. And we were kind of, you know, we're all kind of like, oh, I'm dying, you know, and slightly depressed, but you know you can get back in, and we like to think that our best pieces are yet to come. You know, we're never satisfied with what we have.
Okay, a little torch on the back, maybe.
Back or on the lift?
The back, I guess. I don't know, maybe the lift right now. The back seems to be blown out pretty far already.
I like to think that just seeing the work, again, brings pleasure to people, whether they're sick or not, I guess. But I think maybe where it gets more into really having an effect on people would be if they, which I think what is interesting, what University of Kentucky Hospital is doing here is not just showing the work, but maybe trying to make people understand what goes into making it. And so, I think sometimes I know when people, hopefully my students, sometimes see it and are maybe inspired to do something with their life, you know, or do something, you know, there's just, you can create things and maybe to understand how incredible it is to create something that's your own. And, you know, so I guess more to inspire, not just by bringing joy by looking at the pieces, but maybe starting to understand what's involved in making it. Like you saw the teamwork that's involved in making it, you know, and my hope is that all those people on my team go out and do their own thing also. They feel that incredible sense of creative.